Hello everyone. This is Akash Kulkarni from Spintly. First of all, I would like to welcome all of you all to this webinar on contactless access control systems. Thanks a lot for taking time out of your very busy schedule. Now, before I proceed to introduce our speaker for today, I'll just briefly go through the agenda of what all we are going to be covering for today. So we'll be covering the various products and solutions that Spintly offers. Then we'll be covering some of the challenges that have been brought about by this COVID-19 crisis, which we all are going through. All our businesses have faced some disruption. So we'll be covering that. And then we'll be having a very brief demo of the cloud-based access control and attendance management software, that is Spintly SAMS. We'll also be having a Q&A session later on once this webinar is done, so wherein you all can ask your questions. We'll be unmuting you all then. You all can ask your questions. And meanwhile, if you all have any questions during the webinar itself, please feel free to type it out in the chat window. Audrey from our side will be monitoring all the questions, and she'll be asking those questions to Rohin at the end. You will also be able to unmute yourself and ask them yourself. So our speaker for today is Rohin Parker. He's the Chief Executive Officer at Spintly. He's the visionary behind the cutting-edge technologies which have been developed by Spintly. Rohin will be covering those in more detail. So he has experience of working with the industry leaders in the wireless communication sector globally. He has worked with Nokia, Broadcom. He then returned to India and started Spintly in late 2017. So Spintly has now grown to over 25 members, and it has a partner network which is 100 plus strong, more than 100 plus dealers, system integrators in this network now. So without further ado, I'll hand it over to Rohin to take this discussion ahead.
I'll be covering what products we offer under the brand name Spintly. So Spintly was started in around 2017. One of the flagship products we launched was our smartphone-based contactless access control system, which we launched in 2018. And after that, we have launched quite a few products, which I'll be covering. So when we started the company, we found that there were a few issues with the way access control systems were being deployed, and I'll explain them here. One of the things we found out when we started deploying is there was a huge central controller, which is typically used in all access control systems, which typically occupies a huge cabinet. This is one of our actual deployments where we replaced a wired system with our wireless system. So if you have 20 doors, you will have a rack full of cabinet controllers in the server room, which will be connected to each of the readers on all the doors. That is one of the issues we saw, that there is excessive wiring which is needed in access control systems. Other problem we saw is getting data. Most of the companies now have moved to cloud-based applications for their HR or payroll management, and they need this access control data to be integrated with these softwares. Currently, the way they were doing it, they were downloading the data and importing it manually. So it was a manual process. It was not a seamless integration. It was another problem we saw. And third problem we saw was the methods of access. Cards are very commonly used, but you need to manage the cards. People forget their cards. And then if people forget their cards, then you have to give them a replacement card. Other methods are like fingerprint access, which is very commonly used. The inefficiency there is you have to enroll everybody. So if you have a multi-location, you have to enroll everybody. 1,000 employees, you have to enroll 1,000 people. And recently you saw when fingerprint-based access was banned across the country because of this coronavirus, most of the people had to actually stop using these devices. Keys for security people, they have to maintain a bunch of keys. So these are the set of problems which we observed in the access control space. and we developed Spintly to solve all these problems. The way we solved it is we actually developed a wireless gateway which connects to all the readers on the doors using a wireless mesh network. So this enables us to eliminate all the cabling which is typically needed for access control system. So now if you have 20 doors or 50 doors in a building, you just have to install a reader on the door and connect it to the lock locally, and they will talk, the doors will talk to each other and to a gateway which is centrally located somewhere in the building. And we enable mobile based access, which now lets companies eliminate use of cards, so everybody can actually access the doors using a smartphone app. We also support card based access for people who might not have a smartphone or don't have access to a smartphone. And we also actually support fingerprint based access for certain customer segments who don't allow cards or smartphones in their premises. This gateway is connected to the cloud, continuously connected directly to the cloud, either using your local Wi-Fi network or LAN network or any other cellular network. And our cloud, through our cloud platform, we offer a software solution for enterprise access and attendance management, which we call SAMS. And we also offer third-party integration, which enables other software platforms to talk to our cloud. For example, if you have your emails in G Suite, we can import employees from G Suite, or you can import using an Excel. Or if you have a Microsoft directory, we can import from there. We can also export data to other softwares like payroll management software, HRMS softwares. So we allow API-based integration with other softwares. So this is our solution. Now going to the recent challenges which were faced by companies due to coronavirus crisis, which has happened recently. Fingerprint-based access, attendance and access control systems were completely banned because of the scare of spreading this disease. Some of these machines do support cards, so people actually went back to cards. But places where the cards were not supported, they had to actually move back to paper-based attendance systems. Spintly actually devices with fingerprint also support mobile-based access. So many of our customers actually directly switched to mobile-based access. We were using fingerprint, but since they were not allowed to use fingerprint, they immediately switched to mobile-based access in many places. So the transition was very smooth. So this is what we offer. We offer mobile-based access. That's our flagship offering, along with card-based access. And our fingerprint readers support all three modes of access: fingerprint, mobile, and card-based access. Mobile-based access is now really picking up across the globe, especially in US and Europe, where it just makes sense, where if you have, say, 1,000 employees spread across the country or across a region, sitting centrally, you can just enable access for everyone. They just have to download their app and they get access. We need minimum infrastructure, no wiring required, so you can switch quickly to our solutions without much of restructuring of your wiring or cabling. And the mobile-based access is one of the most hygienic ways of gaining access to your offices or even marking your attendance when you walk into the office. So we've been in business for last year and a half or so doing sales. These are some of our key customers we've acquired. They are mainly in the market segments are mainly offices, IT offices, software offices, real estate companies, industrial customers, hospitality. We have some hospitality customers. We have co-living and co-working customers, which are a major customer base of ours. And so we have a wide range of customer profiles we offer solutions to. So these are the market segments which we offer solutions to. And we operate through our system integrators and dealers in various cities. And they target these particular market segments. The main market segment which we offer solutions for are the small and large enterprises, which are all types of businesses, either software companies, or any company which has employees who need access and their attendance needs to be managed. So we offer access and attendance management solutions for them. I'll be going through the software quickly later on. Co-working spaces are another market segment we offer solutions to. Again, they are spread across, they have across the cities with multiple locations. So they need to manage accesses to their people who can move from one location to another, even across cities. Co-living space is another upcoming trend across the metro cities. So we offer access control solutions to them. And hospitality and residential segment are also our target segments. So how does our system work? So what happens is once a customer takes up a Spintly access control and attendance management solution, the admin can grant access to all the users in one shot through their smartphone. Users get an email and a notification that they're supposed to download an app. So they download the app and they register, they log in and they get access to the doors which they are supposed to, they have been given access. Now these doors can be anywhere across the globe. If you move offices or floors, you will have access. So the onboarding process is very seamless, very smooth. You don't have to call the employees to collect their cards or anything. So they start using their app immediately to access the doors. And the access data is real-time recorded on our cloud-based platform. And the admin or the management can start analyzing this data. They can generate reports, attendance reports, all sorts of things, which I'll cover during our software demo. And then they can create integrations with their existing systems. So they say they have a HRMS system. We are integrated with HRMS software called Great HR, another software called Extenta HRMS. So we push attendance data into their system directly and you can generate payroll from that software. So this is how, in short, it works, the system works. These are the products which we offer. Spintly Uno is the first product which we launched in the market. It is a mobile and a card-based access control reader, which goes on the doors. The second product which we launched is the fingerprint biometric access control unit, which allows fingerprint, mobile, and card-based access. We also have an outdoor unit, which is used in apartment complexes or even offices which have an outdoor barrier, like a boom barrier. This is a waterproof IP67 unit. We also have a door lock, which we offer in the hospitality segment for access control. And then this, we have the gateway, which is the heart of the system, which connects to all these locks wirelessly and also connects to the internet. So these are the hardware products which we offer. Now these products can integrate with different types of access control barriers. We can integrate with EM locks. We can integrate with flap barriers or turnstiles for indoor use. We can integrate with the elevators. We have integrated with elevators where we give access control solutions in an elevator. So if you have access, only then you can operate the elevator. Now we also started giving out a touchless, contactless elevator control solutions where you don't have to touch any buttons. Using your app, you can call the elevator, go inside, select the floor on your app, whichever floor you want to go to, and get off on that floor without touching the elevator. It becomes really relevant now with this coronavirus thing being spreading across. We also support outdoor barriers like boom barriers, sliding gates. So these are the integrations, hardware integrations we offer. And finally, we have our software, which is a cloud-based software, which allows you to monitor access and attendance to your users and employees. So what I will be doing right now is I'll be actually doing a hands-on demo of the software. I'll walk through the software so you can understand how the whole process works when once a customer comes on board the system. Okay, so this is what the software dashboard looks like. Once you log in, you'll be welcomed on a dashboard. So if you are a first time login, you will not see any data here. You will have to set up your organizations. So first thing you'll have to do is actually go and set up your organization by going to organization settings. So what you have to do is specify the name of your organization, which will typically be already populated. The location, your email, phone number of the admin. You upload your company's logo. So that will appear here. And then you define something called as attributes, custom attributes, which are unique to your organization. For example, this organization has defined male and female as an attribute. So gender is an attribute and values as male and female. They have defined another attribute called department, and there are different departments they have defined. Now you can define an attribute just by clicking here, and you can say floor. Then you can define values, say first floor, second floor, third floor. Or you can define an attribute called location. And you can define, say, Bangalore location, Mumbai location. So this will allow you to later on filter data or generate reports based on particular attributes. Say, I want an attendance report for the finance department. So you'll get a report for that. So you set up your own attribute based on your organization's hierarchy, internal setting. The way your organization is set up. And here you specify the attendance settings. So if you have shifts, by default, there will be a general shift defined already, 9:30 to 6 p.m. You can modify it. Then you can add additional shifts like morning shift, evening shift, and specify the timings of those shifts. And you can actually assign users to the shifts here. And we have a detailed shift management utility here, which I will go through at the end. Once you've created shifts, you also define your attendance barriers. So only the main doors can be defined as attendance units. The internal doors can be skipped. They are just for access control. So attendance is counted only for the main doors, or depending on which doors you want to be selected. This is for access type settings, is to allow to control the range of the mobile phone from how far you want to be able to open the door. Level one being closest, where it's like 1 foot, you can open the door only from 1 foot away from the door. Level five being the maximum, or actually L max being the maximum, where you can open the door from even 20 meters away. So you can define it for an organization based on how you want your users to operate the doors. You can also control this at user level. So go to the user and you can specify more range for a particular user. This is the integration setting for Great HR. We have leave management, where you can define the types of leaves you have for your organization. You can define the number of leaves, number of limits per year, whether they're paid or not paid. Then also you can define the holidays in advance for every financial year, how many holidays you have. So if a person doesn't come on a holiday, it is not marked absent. It's marked as a holiday. So this is how you set up your organization. So once you come back to your dashboard, you will see the total number of users. So that you will see only after you enroll your users. You'll see number of doors you have. You'll see a snapshot of today's attendance. So every shift wise attendance, for example, it shows here nobody is in this organization. Let's go here. It shows there are 7 people who have come in today in this organization and 36 have not come in, but everybody is late. So at a given point of time, you can check the status of how many people are late, how many are on time. And this is the recent check-in history, which you'll see all the time. Who has the last check-in? This is a detailed access history. It's a log, continuous log of people going in and out of organizations. So if you have 2 units, one for entry, one for exit, you will see entry and exit in the direction column. This one only has a attendance unit, so you don't see a direction. So user management allows you to add users, remove users, or modify the access for users. So the way to add users is You can add a single user from here by filling his details, or you can actually import multiple users using a file, a CSV file or a Excel file. You just drag and drop your Excel file here, and then you do mapping of the columns to particular fields like name, email address, etc. And all the users, say you have 1,000 users, all 1,000 users will be imported in one shot. Let's go to attendance settings, attendance management page. So this shows you a daily view of your attendance, and it shows the first entry of every employee, the status, quick status of whether he's present or absent. So all these people are absent here. So this is a daily view. You can filter here on say a day. So I want to see yesterday's, I can just select yesterday, or I can select a particular department for example. I can say report for a particular department. Similarly, you can look at weekly and monthly attendance in a table format. Again, this is also available in overall view and detailed view. I'll not go into too many details of this. There are a lot of features here. One of the most important features here, calendar view, which shows you a quick calendar view of the attendance on monthly basis. So this is an April attendance. So because of current shutdown, everybody is absent in this organization. But you can go to a previous organization and previous month and look at the data, say February. If you look at February, you see that everybody is present, and you'll get a summary here at the end, which shows how many presents, how many absents, how many week offs were there. We also give overtime data. Which gives you how much total overtime the employee has done. So many organizations use this data to pay the overtime salaries. And this is loss of pay data, which we usually export to payroll softwares. So if a person is absent for say 2 days, 2 days pay is deducted. If he has not put a leave, or if it's not a holiday, if he has put a leave or a holiday, then there's is not marked absent. So this is the attendance management feature which we have. And there is a shift management feature. The shift management feature actually lets you define shifts for your employees. So everybody is in general shift here in this particular case. You can change the shift to a different shift here for particular employees, or you can do something called as bulk assign. Where you can assign shifts to a group of people. So you say 10 people are in, so you define the shift, say afternoon shift, then I just select the users for that particular shift. So all the people will be in that shift, and you can say that this shift, this particular setting is applicable from today up to say next week or next month. And next month you can come and update the shift for everyone. So this way you can quickly assign shift to multiple people. And here, if you want to make quick changes, this calendar view enables you to change shifts of people. Say somebody wants to exchange a shift with somebody else, you can come and make that change here quickly. Also, it gives you a snapshot here. So this is reflected in the attendance view of the in the calendar view. So their attendance is based on the shifts here. So we also allow week offs on other days other than Saturday, Sundays. You can actually define week offs on Wednesdays or Thursdays. So it's a detailed shift management or shift roster feature which we offer. We also have a visitor management feature which is enabled on the customer's request. Currently, it's disabled here, which allows you to manage your visitors. So if a visitor comes to the front desk, instead of he writing his name on a register and his phone number on a paper-based register, he can log in, he can do a self-check-in on a tablet-based self-check-in kiosk or a tablet, where he enters his phone number and name and email address, and the notification goes to the person who is supposed to meet, and he approves the request quickly on his through his smartphone app, and then the security guard will let him in once the approval has come. So there is a visitor log which is maintained on our cloud. So this gives you a very accurate log of your visitors, and also gives privacy to the visitors who are entering your organization by entering their phone number on a tablet instead of writing it on a piece of paper, which is visible to everyone. So these are the software, various software features which we offer within attendance management or within leave management. Actually, on the app, the features which are available for users are, they can access the doors, first of all, using the app. Secondly, they can apply for leaves from their app, and they can see the leaves, whether the leaves are approved or not. The admin can actually approve leaves from the app itself for his employees. Another feature which I skipped is managers. So in users, when you are creating users, there is a feature called manager. So you can define a person as a manager, and once you have defined a manager, you can make some people report to him. So when you do, you can actually then select a person's manager who he reports to. So a manager has the right to approve the leaves for his team, and he can also see their attendance, manage their attendance. So that's about the software. So that's all the presentation I had. I will be able to answer any questions right now. If somebody has asked questions on the chat window, I'll be able to take that up, or I'll be able to questions directly from users. You can, there's a feature called raise your hand in Zoom. You can raise your hand and ask questions. Omkar,
so we have, yeah.
Yes, hello sir.
Hi.
Hi, sir. अभी आपने जो बताया जो manager create करके हम like particular group को वो assign कर सकते हैं manager, okay?
हाँ.
So अभी actually हमारे पास हम like हमारे पास होता है एक software में उसमें हमें like दिक्कत ऐसे आ रही है मैं client ने हमें वैसा बताया कि manager क्या करते हैं manager खुद के लिए वो apply करते हैं वहीं से और वो directly approve भी हो जाता है इसका like mobile app के through ओपन करते तो इसमें भी अगर हमने पर्टिकुलर मैनेजर वो अपनी खुद के लिए अप्लाई करके अप्रूव कर सकता है क्या ऐसा
नहीं होता नहीं मैनेजर यूजुअली क्या अगर मैनेजर है मैनेजर का भी मैनेजर होगा
ओके
ठीक है तो उसको अप्रूव करना पड़ेगा मैनेजर के मैनेजर को अप्रूव करना पड़ेगा
ओके मैनेजर के मैनेजर को अगर मैनेजर ने उसके मोबाइल ऐप के थ्रू लीव अप्लाई कर दी तो डायरेक्टली अप्रूव नहीं हो सकती वो
नहीं होगी वो उसके मैनेजर को जाएगी
क्योंकि हाँ क्योंकि हम जो अभी यूज कर रहे हैं सॉफ्टवेयर उसमें ये दिक्कत आ रही है कि डायरेक्टली मैनेजर क्या करता है अपने लिए अप्लाई करता है वो ये अप्रूव करता है
नहीं ऐसा नहीं होगा
ओके ओके या यही पूछना
थैंक यू आई थिंक वेंकटेश बबलाडी हैज अ क्वेश्चन
हेलो
या हाय
हाय अच्छा आई वांट टू नो वेदर दिस software is installed on the cloud, right?
Yeah, it is a cloud-based software.
Okay. If some client wants to install it on a web-based server, their server, own server, then?
We have an offline solution which doesn't have all these features.
It
offers only limited features of attendance reports and access history.
Okay.
So you can get that features offline through our gateway. So we don't have a offline software offering it as yet.
Okay, okay. So this all your soft devices, hardware devices, can be connected to this cloud, the
yes.
application. Okay, can you just show us again all the devices and their specification? The devices start to
starting. These are devices.
Yeah, basic device and.
Yeah, let me just open some of the specifications for these devices. I mean, we can always share it with you over email, the data sheets of the devices. But
yeah,
let me open one example specification sheet. Are you able to see?
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is for the mobile and card-based access control unit.
Okay.
So main specifications are its voltage. It can take anything between 9 and 30 volt DC input for powering up. So usually it uses the same power supply which is used for which you have.
Okay.
Maximum current amps. This is the power consumption. These are the temperature ratings, size. It has a relay contact, NO and NC. So depending on your configuration, to be continuously locked. So if it is in parallel or series, you have to put it in parallel or sometimes in series. So based on that, you can use NO.
Okay. How many devices can be?
There is no limit on number of devices, and in theory, it is 32,000 per gateway.
Okay.
Actually.
Okay. And how many users can be imported into the software? That means employees.
So mobile. So as far
how
as
many employees.
There is again no limit in the software. But
okay.
For fingerprint per device, it is 3,000 employees which can be supported.
Software,
no,
there,
in
is,
software there is no limit.
No limit. Okay. No. Device, it is 3,000.
On device, there is 3,000 limit on the fingerprint based unit. But if,
okay.
if you are giving mobile based access, again on device also there is no limit.
No. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah,
Hello,
thank
Rohan.
You. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. Anything else, Venkatesh?
No. Thank you.
Yeah, we'll share the data sheets with you offline. All the data sheets for your reference.
Yeah.
Hello, Rohan.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have another question from Mr. Saurav. He asks whether if a person is neither a admin or a manager, then in what category it will be, and also
yeah.
he wants to know what has to be done when adding a user.
So by default, a user is an end user, so he doesn't have any privileges. So he cannot see other people's attendance. He's a normal user. It's called an end user. If you make him an admin, that means he can actually see everybody's attendance. So he's able to manage everybody. Now a manager will only be able to manage his group of people. So if there are say 20 people reporting to a manager, he can only manage those 20 people's attendance. So by default, a user is end user. Other question was about adding users, you said, right?
Yeah.
So what is the question?
You wanted to know what has to be done while adding users.
Okay, for end customer, I think. So he's asking about end customer. So nothing has to be selected. So we are changing that feature to make it a little bit more user friendly. Where when you're adding a user, we will be adding a third option here called end user. So you have to at least select one of them here. So by default, if you don't select any admin or manager, he's an end user. But we have received feedback from the customer that it is a little confusing. So we'll be adding another selection here for end user. Yeah, I hope that answers Saurabh's question.
Yeah, he got it.
Okay.
Next, I'll be unmuting Mr. Menon. He has a question.
Yes.
Mr. Menon, go ahead.
Hi, good morning, Rohin and team.
Hi,
Rohin, we have been discussing this earlier also. So I want to know whether, we have come to any conclusion on this This is with regards to having a slave device for biometric. So for exit, you already have a biometric device, but for entry. For entry, you have a biometric device, but for exit, we don't have that. So generally, what we do is that we install the same unit, right?
Correct.
So is there any plans to come out with a slave unit?
Yes, we have plans, but it will take at least 4 to 5 months for that to come out. So this will connect to the unit which is sitting outside.
Because we have started, now most of our, one segment of our co-work space has started going in with this Spintly thing. And their clients are now requiring us to install, the slave device, which needs to have a biometric.
Okay. So we will be releasing that slave device. Till then, we can deploy units saying that we'll take this discussion with you directly. It can be a more of a commercial offering we can give them, that at the price of the slave device, we offer a full unit and then replace it with a slave device subsequently.
Okay, done. That answers my question. Thank you.
Thanks, Mohan. You can always send us an email.
Hello.
Yeah.
Rohin, can you just go to the dashboard panel?
Yes.
Okay. You can see? Yeah. How do you configure this for multiple locations? Suppose office is there, head office, and plus multiple location branches are there. So how do you configure location wise, you said?
Yeah, so you can go to organization settings and define custom attributes called a location. Okay. And specify the number of locations.
Okay, these all hardwares are having this push data, this thing. So data can be pushed to centrally. Or
yes.
Do we have...
Okay. No, data will be pushed centrally. So there will be a gateway at each location.
If
we have five locations, there will be five gateways. They will be connected to the cloud. They will push data. The data will come to this central location. Now, when you're creating users, right? What you will do is when you're creating user, since you have defined a location as an attribute, it will show here, select location. You can, for that user, you specify his location. That is one thing. And also devices will have, so access barriers will have location here. So every device also will be identified. So where it is, whether it is in your Bangalore office or whichever office it is. And all the data will be accordingly filtered out based on location. You can always email us at either sales@spintly.com or support@spintly.com, and we'll respond to you immediately with an answer. If you need more information like product data sheets or software information or software demo, we have a YouTube channel where we have software videos of how to use some of our features which I explained. Or we can send you details about the product. Installation. We also have installation videos if system director is interested in understanding how the devices can be installed and configured. We will also provide that information. So if there are no more questions, then we will wrap up this webinar. It was a thanks to everyone who took out time to attend this webinar, and we're looking to working with some of you once the crisis is over. There are a few exciting opportunities we are working on, especially on touchless contactless access area. We have orders for elevator access where people don't want to touch elevators anymore. So these are some of the opportunities which are in line once this crisis is over. So thank you again, and you stay home and stay safe. Let's hope for the best. Thank you.